Do your piano students learn enough music history, in your opinion? I know this is something that I've struggled to teach, and you can see actually my composer timeline up here at the moment, which is one of the things I do to bring this to the forefront. But that's not what I'm going to talk to you about today. What I want to talk to you about is actually some books, because I also have a lending library with, yes, music books with sheet music to read, but also with books to actually read about music and music history and composers. And what I want to share with you today is my top five. So whether you're a piano parent and looking for a gift for, perhaps for your child, a stocking stuffer or something like that, or whether you're a teacher and you need to build up your library, I want to share with you my absolute favorite five books. The first book I want to share with you is possibly my favorite. It's Do Re Mi, If You Can Read Music, Thank Guido d'Arezzo. This is such a wonderful, interesting, and unique book. I can't speak about it highly enough. It is absolutely awesome. It's got the most beautiful illustrations you've ever seen. They're absolutely gorgeous. And it tells the story of a monk, Guido d'Arezzo, who wanted to write down music. You may not have thought back this far even yourself, but music wasn't always written down. And this tells the story of how music notation began to be invented by this monk and what prompted it and the difference it made for music. It's a wonderful story, but it also gives students an insight and helps to concrete and solidify the idea of how the staff works it when they're reading from music, where that came from, and why there are lines and spaces and all of this stuff that we use to read music today. So that one I highly recommend. That's number one. The next one is Lemony Snicket, The Composer Is Dead. Now, I absolutely love Lemony Snicket, so I knew I would love this book. And when it came, it was recommended by another teacher friend of mine. And when it came, I was so excited and I loved it just as much as I thought I would. So this is another picture book. I'm going in this video roughly in order of age, reading level or picture book status rather. So this is a picture book as well. Students could either read it for themselves at a certain age. That's about what the font is like. So they would need to be fairly confident with reading to read it themselves. But of course, a parent or a teacher could read it to them. It tells the story of the composer is dead. And then he asks each of the different instruments and families of instruments in the orchestra questions to try and get to the bottom of why the composer died. So you get to know the different instruments of the orchestra in this completely unique way, and it's wonderfully illustrated, and it comes with a CD with a narration and orchestra playing and all of that. So wonderful book. Number three is the last picture book officially, and that's The Music of Life, which is about Bartolomeo Cristofori and the invention of the piano. And obviously I'm a piano teacher, so I have a soft spot for this, but I truly think that the piano is one of the most fascinating instruments in terms of how it works and where it came from and its history and all of that. And I just love that they created this book about it. So in this book, they go through how it came to come about, and they deal with the fact that it's piano forte and the forte is for loud, piano for soft, and all of that. So I'll let you read the actual book, but definitely grab this one. It's fantastic, and the illustrations are again beautiful in that one. Number four is The Lives of the Musicians. So this time the subtitle, Good Times, Bad Times, and What the Neighbors Thought, which I really like. So this one is really for older students who can read quite well, unless a parent is going to read it to them. And it takes you through various different composers. I like that it's quite brief about each different composer, tells some interesting stories. It's very engaging, and they've got an illustration beside them. And the other thing I like about this is that he's attempted to include some women. So Nadia Boulanger is there. And the choice of composers is generally interesting. You know, you've got Erik Satie, Gilbert and Sullivan. It covers a huge breadth, as well as some of the key names, you know, that was Brahms that I just flipped past there. So there's a good wide variety of composers in there. I'd like more women, but that's just me. But really good stories and nice and succinct. And then this one is my favorite for older students to read as they get to know music history. So this is Why Beethoven Threw the Stew. There's another one, a companion book, follow-up, whatever you want to call it, called Why Handel Waggled His Wig. I just love the style of this author. So it's by Stephen Isserlis. I don't know how to say his surname, but his writing is wonderful. And I love what he says in the foreword of this book, because he mentions how his piano teacher growing up, I think he's a pianist, anyway, his teacher growing up told him all these stories like she knew the composers, and he wants to give his students and other students that feeling too, like they're getting to know the composers and yeah, really get inside their personalities and connect with them. So he tells great stories, he gives you good insight, and it's written in a very engaging way. I have one quibble with this, which is me being pedantic, but the formatting is not perfect. And I haven't even looked, but is it a publisher? Oh, it is Faber and Faber. Someone should have formatted it correctly then. I thought it was going to be self-published. This should be justified. It shouldn't be left aligned. But that's my pickiness. Otherwise, it's beautiful. I love the way it's laid out, the facts of life, and the different suggestions of what they should listen to as well. So those are my top five. If I have to pick one absolute favorite one, it is that first one, Do Re Mi, because I just think it's so unusual and fantastic that someone chose to tell that story. I think it's wonderful, and I love the illustrations in that one. I think they're absolutely gorgeous and such an interesting style. I hope that you'll check out one of these. Maybe one of them was new to you, maybe all of them were, and that you'll buy them for your students or for your piano kid if you're a piano parent, and that you have fun with them, because getting to know music history doesn't have to be dull at all. If you have further suggestions of ones to add, please do let me know in the comments below, because I'm always looking for new suggestions, and I do have a more comprehensive list on my blog as well, so I'll leave a link to that below this in the description directly below this video. Enjoy!